Good evening and welcome to Views with Joyce Waddell. I want to thank you for joining us this evening. We have an interesting show for you. We're going to be talking about finding my sister. Our topic for tonight is finding my sister. We're going to be talking with two sisters who for a long time didn't know that they were sisters. And the joy, the excitement, the thrill, the exhilaration of finding a sibling is a blessing. Mm-hmm. They're going to share their story and what it really means when you find someone that you love. It's just like they were with you all the time. So welcome, Yolanda.
Thank you.
And welcome, Dorothea.
Hi, how are you?
So finding your sister was like finding someone that you really love, that you never... Someone that went away, who went away, and all of a sudden you found them.
Mm-hmm.
And I've heard stories of it so many times. I had one gentleman here, and he was talking about he found his father, mm-hmm. and his father was teaching in Florida. And what was exciting to him, the father did not know. He traced the father. The father did not know it. And all he wanted to do was just to lay his eyes mm-hmm. on his father.
Mm-hmm.
So he went to the classroom where the father was. And they, you know, met. And it was not a great experience. The father really mm-hmm. did not want to see him. So sometimes the person, they don't want to connect mm-hmm. again.
That's true.
But for him, inside, it was something that, like something that was missing. Mm-hmm. And made him whole because he had an opportunity to just see this man,
mm-hmm.
to lay eyes on him and see him in action.
Mm-hmm.
But for the two of you, you were living in the same town.
Mm-hmm.
Were you?
Same town, Wilmington, yeah. North Carolina.
Did you go to the same high school?
No.
You did?
Age difference.
Yeah,
major there's an age difference.
Yeah. That's the reason that you didn't go to the same high school. Did you go to the same church?
No.
Why? If you were living in the same town, you must have crossed paths once at some point, didn't you?
You would think, because Wilmington is so small, but we did not, you know.
Not ever?
Mm-hmm. Nope.
And there were other people in town, I'm sure, who knew this and did not share it with you. Sometimes they share it with you and you ignore what they say because you think they don't know what they're talking about.
Mm-hmm.
Were there other people in the town that shared it with you?
Well, not that I was familiar with.
Yeah.
Often, they knew, didn't they?
Well, there were people on my end of it that knew my mother because the woman that raised me raised my mother till she was about 15 or 16 when she had me.
So she was like your grandmother.
Mm-hmm. Yes. And so the woman who adopted me knew my mother. And so my adopted family kind of knew my mother. And so... There were always whispers. I knew growing up with them, I didn't look like them. I was always the oddball, you know, and I would often cry and say, I'm just not like anybody, and never knowing why. And but moving to Wilmington was the breaking point. And but there was always whispers, always whispers.
They were whispering. Did they tell you?
No.
In the whispers?
No. No one ever told me... you know, who my mother was or that I had a mother. And as you know, I didn't know I had a sister or brothers either. So we were living in the same town and never bumped into each other and never knew.
And you wondered why you didn't look like the other, well, you didn't have other siblings with this growing
no,
up mother.
I was an only child.
And you wonder why you didn't look like her.
Right. And cousins didn't look like my cousins. And
did the cousins look like each other?
Yes.
And they look like other cousins?
Yes.
Well, I have cousins and we don't look alike.
Well, that's what we do. Mm-hmm. We tend to, you know, say to ourselves, that's what I did. Well, mm-hmm. you know, you don't always have to look alike to be family. So mm-hmm. that's why, you know, it didn't make a difference with me.
You know? You thought it was something odd.
Yes, always.
And during that time, too, adoption was very informal.
Right.
So if you weren't able to raise a child, a loved one or relative would say, I'll take the child, mm-hmm. and, you know, raise the child as my own. And so it wasn't as if it was a formal adoption.
Mm-hmm. No, a lot of in mm-hmm. small towns, a lot of mm-hmm. a lot of families would say, because they knew where the children were, mm-hmm. they would say, you know, well, you can take this one, or you mm-hmm. can take this one.
Mm-hmm. That's right.
And they give them to mm-hmm. relatives. So that was mm-hmm. nothing unusual about
right.
it.
Yeah, that's
but
so
usually,
true.
If the child knew, they'd always want to come back home to the mother.
Oh mm-hmm. yes. Mm-hmm. Oh yes. Mm-hmm.
So a lot of times they didn't want them to know, but this. That happens all
true.
The time in small
still
towns.
Does.
Oh,
mm-hmm.
yes, still mm-hmm. happens.
Mm-hmm. Without being formal adoption. Mm-hmm. Did you know?
I knew.
All
I
the
knew
time.
Because my mom would always say, our mom would say, I have five kids and, you know, their names are, and I would see pictures of some and, you know, so, mm-hmm. But I never knew my oldest sister. I knew that I had brothers and I had pictures of them. Mm-hmm. No real contact. I mm-hmm. think... up until 18, I'd only seen my brothers once.
Mm-hmm. Did they can't come to visit you?
We went to visit them.
In mm-hmm. New York?
Mm-hmm. In Pennsylvania. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
So you, with your mother.
Mm-hmm.
But you never came to visit her.
Well, at that time, we had met by
yeah,
then.
Yeah, we had met yeah. by then, yes. And we
okay.
took a trip up there to mm-hmm. meet our brothers, you know. So it was quite exciting.
How was it when the brothers saw you and they hadn't seen you before?
Just excited.
Excited.
Mm-hmm. You still communicate with them?
Yes, I live
yes.
now one block from,
yes.
from one of my brothers.
In Sulphur?
Mm-hmm. mm-hmm. mm-hmm.
Yeah. He moved there because of you?
I think so.
Yeah.
I like to think so.
Oh, this we're talking about finding my sister. This is the topic for tonight. And the reason that we're talking about this is we're talking about the excitement.
Mm.
Two sisters coming together. Later in life, not in older life, early in life, but not as very, very young children, uniting with each other and sharing their story of how they came together. Finding my sister is our topic for today. So you knew.
Mm-hmm.
And she was in Wilmington. Did you know then?
Well, actually, I was in New York first. Mm-hmm. I was mm-hmm. born in New York with my adopted mother.
And she moved down here.
Right. Mm-hmm. And we moved to Wilmington.
With the adopted mother.
Yes. And that's where my biological mother and sister was living also in Wilmington.
Did she know that?
My biological mom.
Did your adopted mom know?
Oh, no, absolutely not.
She didn't know where she was.
She didn't know that my biological mother was in Wilmington also.
Had she known, do you think she would have moved there?
Probably not.
Yeah, we moved a lot during that time.
Yeah.
We were in Florida for a while. We were in Jacksonville, North Carolina for a while, and then we eventually moved mm-hmm. to Wilmington.
Mm-hmm.
So we were kind of all over the place. So I'm sure she didn't know.
She
couldn't
did not
keep up
know.
With that.
Yeah.
That was a lot of moving,
mm-hmm.
wasn't it?
Mm-hmm. A lot of moving.
I mean, to different states.
Mm-hmm.
From Jackson, from Florida.
Sanford, Florida.
Mm-hmm. Tampa.
Sanford.
That's way down in Florida,
mm-hmm.
isn't it?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, that's a lot of moving. Mm-hmm. So you didn't know that she was your sister in Wilmington.
I didn't know she was in Wilmington until my mom found out, and I'm not quite sure how she found out,
yeah. but mm-hmm. she knew.
Mm-hmm.
She probably knew all the time, didn't she?
Mm-hmm. I'm not sure.
Yeah.
I don't think so.
But she had to know how to get sitting in the car.
Word of mouth, mm-hmm. you know, it's a small mm-hmm. town. She could have ran into some of my mm-hmm. adopted family, and they might have told her, the lady who raised you, my mother, was now living in Wilmington, and, mm-hmm. you know, your daughter's probably with her, you know.
Mm-hmm.
So
your mom was able to get everybody.
Well,
not quite recently,
was it 2 years ago?
Yeah.
For the first time, all of my siblings were together in one place for the first time yeah. ever.
That was our first Thanksgiving together.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, really?
Ever, yes. And that was quite overwhelming. Mm-hmm. It was quite overwhelming.
In Salisbury.
Mm-hmm. mm-hmm.
All bad.
Yes.
Where were the other two?
One lives in Clinton and one is in Ohio.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
Did they ever try to locate you?
Mm-hmm.
Yes,
mm-hmm.
they tried.
Yeah. And they couldn't?
No, I often had conversations mm-hmm. with them, like over the phone, but never any real like face-to-face contact.
Mm-hmm. The two in the one in Clinton and Ohio.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
Clinton's not that far from mm-hmm. Wilmington, is
I know.
Mm-hmm. We used to visit Clinton all the time.
But you didn't know he was there?
Didn't know where.
Mm-hmm.
Well, what happened that you connected with him?
Well, my mom at some point was able to determine and figure out where he was located. And so then we all took a trip there to meet my youngest sibling.
Right.
Or our youngest sibling.
Yes, he was very young, too. So I'm sure he was probably didn't understand the whole, you know, scope of what was going on. But
he was young when you met him.
And I think he was kind of confused, not really knowing who we were. I think he may have been told that we were something, a different relationship to him than what we were.
And see, that's the thing about the whole thing about when kids are taken away from the family. Unfortunately, there are lies told to the children. And as an adult now, I didn't understand it at that time. The lady who raised me, you know, not coming forth to tell me the whole truth. But as an adult, I can understand her fear of losing me as a child. And so that helped me cope with some of the lies that was told. Doesn't make, you know, make it right to lie, but I can understand why she did it.
Yeah, it could have been, for a number of reasons.
You're right.
Right.
She felt it was the best thing to do, and probably at that time it was. So the youngest sibling, when he met you, he couldn't put it all together. When was he able to put this together?
I guess during my teenage years, I would constantly make contact. I would go to the telephone booth and put the quarters and dimes in and call everyone once I was able to get in touch with everyone. So for a while, there wasn't any contact. And I think during those times, you really do have to respect the space of others. Everyone's not ready for to be reunited and brought into new relationships. And so I think when the time was right, you know, he came forward and became more of a part of our lives.
Yes.
And sometimes people never want to be brought into a new relationship.
So That's true. It's just too overwhelming for them.
Sometimes they just don't want it. It may not be overwhelming. That's a choice.
Yes.
A personal choice.
Yes.
They want to keep things like they've known it to be. And don't want changes in their life.
Right.
That's so true.
And so sometimes the person is yours. So as going forward, what happens now with the youngest one? Does he readily accept being in the...
Oh, yes. He comes down
often. You know, we're all older now, and he's in his...
What, 30s?
And so we get together, and it's just amazing, the dynamics of being that we were all separated. It's just, it's no animosity. It's just, it's just love. You know, we know that we're blessed to even have this chance to be together.
You know, I saw that happen to a family when they got together. It was like they were all angry. You've heard that?
Yes, I have. I've heard stories like that.
They're angry about what happened. And so then they're angry with each other. I've seen that. Honest, we're going to pause for a moment as we talk about finding my sister. And how exciting it was for sisters to find each other. Not only to find the two of them, the only two girls.
Yes.
Okay. But three boys as well. Three boys. And the youngest one is 30.
In his 30s
now.
Yes, sister. your name, baby?